too. The idea is to combine
this. What's good, YouTube? It's T Customs' first video. So I already had a recorded one for the Gucci Customs, but that got messed up and deleted. But let's just get into it. So today I'm gonna be working on the white cement floor. We're gonna do a whole midsole repaint and a whole cleanup. All right, so I'm gonna make sure y'all can get a close-up view of what these look like before. And this is after they're clean, by the way, so they look way better than they did already. But you know, I'm gonna just walk you guys through how to make them look brand new again. So yeah, let's get into it, guys. So step one, what we have to do is we're gonna have to tape up the midsoles, and we're gonna have to completely acetone them down and strip the paint. Because why I'm doing this, a lot of people ask, there is tons of smudges on here. And just in general, these are just beat to ever. I gotta redo the white anyway, so let's just do that first before anything. And just get the midsole repainted. Because there's really not much doing to this restoration. I dropped the stain in the mood, same, baby. I swear I always wanted one of these, baby. Remember when I didn't have a thing, baby. I swear, man, all I had to do was all I had to do was dream, baby. Dream, baby. Dream, baby. All hey guys, so I just finished off taping up the midsole, at least the cement part, to acetone it. And if you have noticed, I did not really tape perfectly or perfect lines or anything like right there, just because we're gonna paint a white base coat underneath both layers, and I just don't want to acetone and have the gray go under the white, and it causes a huge mess, and it's just hard for the white to shine over the gray.
Girl, you know, good girl, bad time, right place, wrong mind. Got my mind right, hit her back, the wrong line, man. But before I started feeling bad, my nigga text me like I got some hoes, hit me back. Fuck.
Finished acetoning off the cement. Looks pretty good. There's a couple gray spots, but it doesn't matter, I'll be painting right over. So now we're going to strip the bottom paint, and we're going to open up the white, and we're going to strip down that too. So I just finished the acetone for both layers. As you can see, it's got that yellow type look to it, faded kind. But I'm actually going to strip all of the tape and retape the parts, just because acetone does leak sometimes, and I don't want there to be any excess paint underneath the tape. Finished taping up the uppers, we are gonna hop right into the white base coat, and then we're gonna layer down the cement right after. Let's get into it. Guys can see, finished the white base coat. It is looking really, really good. So this bottom part will stay white, of course, for the cement. Now the next step is to tape off the bottom half of the midsole. We're gonna get taped off the top so we can start painting on the gray and some speckles for the cement, and we'll be finished with the midsole. With a pocket full of cottage, yeah. Whoa, chemo, slap it, chopper, aim it, inch it, noggin, yeah. Had to call the addict, then the topper, had to chop it. Skr, skr. Niggas pocket watching, so I gotta keep the rocket. Ooh. Neck, water, faucet, water, mocking, birds, mocking, and pint, stocking. Next, keep biting, neck, wrist on hockey, hockey, wrist on rocket. Finish the whole midsole repaint for the cement base color. Now our next step is we're gonna get some flat black Angulus paint and a toothbrush. Little by little, we're gonna give some speckles up the midsole to get that old cement look, like the heel tab and the wings of the shoe. So let's get into it.
You been plotting, nigga, wasn't you?
should've never even fuck with you. Yeah, I started in the back, had to skip the line, no, I'ma keep that shit a stack till my fucking time go. Niggas throw you in the shade cause they wanna shine, no. Nigga throw me in the grave in the Ferragamo. Man, I can't believe they killed my fucking bro Quado. Shit was so deep, I had to say that with my eyes closed. That shit made me wanna treat a nigga like he John Doe. Nah, I know me Rondo, now that nigga John Doe.
Alright, you guys, so this is the midsole final look after letting it dry overnight. Been about 24 hours, I think. It came out looking very nice. If you feel, it feels as it's one. There's not any bumps or anything that you can feel the speckles. So now the next step we're gonna do is we're gonna strip all the tape back off. We're gonna do a full white touch up around the shoes. We're gonna pick up any scratches or scuffs, and then we're gonna fix the yellowing on the netting, and then we should be done.
I'm an artist, I woke up to a menage, I'm just being honest. I get money if I want it, I'ma cop it. If a nigga wants static, let him have it. Have you ever seen a mini semi-automatic? It go thumb like a drum, hit a beat blasting. When it come to that fire, I'ma fucking drag it. Huh? Nigga, this is what that jungle do. Nigga, this is what that jungle do. Been plotting, nigga, wasn't you? I should've never even fuck with you. I was walking in the rain with my Timbs on, stepping over puddles full of pain. It's a big storm. 13 on my ball, man.
Just finished the full white repaint on these and fixing up the netting. As you can see, it really did come out very nicely. They look very, very nice. There's a couple spots that I couldn't completely cover up because it destroyed the leather. But yeah, so I repainted the netting. Doesn't have that yellow look to it anymore. It's nice and white again. Even did underneath the eyelets, no dirt stains or anything. Knitting white again, lined up the outside. Don't see any paint stains, any paint drips, nothing. So now we're on to our next step. We're gonna get the creases out of the toe box, which we are doing after we paint it. So when it gets warm, some of the paint will sink into the crease spots and hopefully help take them away too. So let's hop into that.
You a blessing, girl, just let me make corrections, yeah. Damn, I've been stressing, yeah.
Alright, y'all, so just finished decreasing the toe box. There is a couple spots you cannot get all creases out, but what we're mostly shooting for is right in this area. You do not see many creases. So I did this to both shoes. Just got iron and a damp rag. Came out looking very nice. So now for the next step, we are going to touch up some of the spots around the outsole down here and also on this part with some just flat black paint. We're gonna go over that, and then also we are going to repaint the pads on the bottom toe and the heel back to that white cement color that they look like when you got them fresh out the box.
Don't be afraid to tell me that it's over. Tell me that it's over. No, I don't deserve you. That shit I never told you. There's too many things I can't look you in the face. I just grab you by the waist and act like everything's okay. Yeah. Bear with me, girl. I'm trying to.
Alright, you guys. So we just finished all of the touch-ups. Repainted the bottom cement again, brought back that feel. That's what it looks like from the view up top. Once again, netting's white, toe box on, got all the creases out, lined it up very nicely. I don't know how many times I've said very nicely, I'm sorry, but yes, the lines came out looking very clean. Redid the bottom pads. Now all that's next is hit it with the finisher. We're gonna glue this little piece back. It's just a minor re-glue. We're gonna re-glue that, then we'll lace them up. We'll be done. For the finisher, I'm gonna just use some Rust-Oleum matte finish, just to spray on. Yes, this, Krylon, anything really works. There's really no difference as long as it's non-yellow.
Broken hearted, he was cheating on.
for this little minor re-glue, just on this little part right here. We're just gonna use some shoe goo, just a paintbrush, an X-Acto knife, and then tape it over and let it sit for about 10 hours. So about once go to sleep, wake up, should be good. Then we can be able to lace them up. So this is the final look after the re-glue. It's nice and clean. Can't even tell that it was not attached for a little bit. So now we're gonna lace them up. Despite her past, she can't help the attraction. He tells her that he's nothing like the last one. He redefines in every way what love is. She fell for him and hasn't gotten up since. Every now and then she goes off though, beating on his chest like a bomb. Red screen shit.
She savage, be with them apes. Play with this shit, you get eight. Bitch, I be covered in baby. Bitch, I be covered in baby. You know I keep me a K. You know I keep me a drink. Go, rap a nigga like a egg roll. Big bullets leave a big hole. I was raised by the G code. Don't bend, nigga, don't fold. My uncle told me how to scrape the bowl. And my auntie still smoking blow. Came from nothing, nigga, we was poor. Eviction notices all on the door. Take out trash for some school clothes. I'm the one that the streets chose. Now I'm on Ocean Drive, sipping codeine with the top down. 20 grand on me, light a jury and a clock. Now I got my own money, pussy nigga, I did not sign. Say Young Savage name in the song and some shots.
Guys, so that's gonna wrap it up on the 2016 White Cement full restore and repaint. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. There is more on the way, tons of more shoes as you can see in the back that I gotta do videos on and work on. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. Share the video, get it some likes. More coming soon. Thank you.
Lot of Jerry and a Glock 9. Lot of Jerry and a Glock 9. I can't leave the house without my Glock.